We have 300 LEDs on a 15 foot long tape with adhesive backing. So let's see what we could do with this right now. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. Now, we have this roll of LEDs right here. They're surface mount LEDs, and these are bright white. And they come in rows of three with a resistor where you could cut them off for three, or you could use the whole roll of the 15 foot. So we're going to talk about what we're going to do with this. There's a lot of different things that we can do with this. We could separate these, we could cut them off, and we could use them in buildings, anywhere that we want to on our layout. We could even put it up high on behind the valance for lighting. If we had some blue ones, which I think I'll get some blue ones later on, we'll be using that up on up behind the valance for nighttime lighting. But for right now, I have some bright white ones right here, and I'm going to show you how you could cut them off, solder leads onto them, and do anything else that you want to for your model railroad. Just like all the other LEDs that I've showed you, these are no different. These are just mounted on an adhesive back tape, and they have a resistor for every three LED on there. Now, the reason for that resistor is a current limiting resistor. That's so you don't burn them up, because if you didn't have that resistor on there, you would just be burning these LEDs out. So I'm going to show you what we can do with this. And as you can see on this one here, what you see online in a catalog or the description that they show might be a little bit different than what they look like here. But basically, they're all the same. You get three LEDs with a resistor in there and a place to cut it off. And on this one, on this particular one here, you have soldering pads on there, which makes it a little bit easier to put leads on there. Some of them, some of the older types, didn't have those soldering pads on there. You had to scrape off the coating on the tape itself just to be able to solder leads onto it. But this one comes with soldering pads on it for every three LEDs. So if you would like to see more videos like this, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and go to my channel. Click right below the video where it says Tom's Trains and Things. Click on that and that'll take you to my channel page, and click on playlists. And that will show you all the playlists that I have. I have them grouped into different categories by topic, so it's easy to find. So if you're looking for something on soldering, you could find it. If you're looking for electrical projects, you could find it. If you're looking for DCC, you'll find it. I have over 40 playlists on there where the videos are grouped into categories so you could find them easily. So take a look at it. So let's get started with this right now. The first thing that I was going to do was I was going to cut off 10 sets of these, so that would be 30 LEDs. And what I noticed on here is they've already done the work for me. They, at every 10 sets, they have these things spliced in. Here's the second one right there, and here's the first one right there. And what they did was they soldered the pads together. So I'm just going to break this off right here, and we're going to work with the first 10 on these leads. And what I'm going to do is show you how to solder on here. But what I might do is I might come up to the next one, up to the 11th one, so I have a good clean soldering pad right here to show you how to solder on it. So we'll just take our X-Acto. You know, before we get started on this, we should be putting in a new blade on our X-Acto tool so we could have a good cut on our tape here. Now we'll take a blade out of here and put it on our handle, and then put the old blade in the dispenser where it says used blades. As you can see on here, we have a good pad where we could solder our wires onto the tape. We're going to take a short section of black and red wire, just about that long right there, and use that as leads. We can make them as long as we want, but I'm just going to make them short just for this demonstration right here. And what I do is I put the one that I cut up against the one that I'm going to cut, the red, and just cut them so they're both the same length. Now we have 22 gauge stranded wire, and I already put some flux on the wire, and I have them set up here on the tweezers and my little alligator clip here. So I'll heat it up. And I'm using a small pointed soldering tip on here. Now, the first one I showed you, I did the solder on the wire. This one, I'm going to put the solder on the tip and let it run on the wire like that. And basically, it's the same thing. One user asked me if I use a fan on here. I normally use a fan to get the smoke out of the way, but when you're filming, it's hard to use the fan because the fan will interfere with the microphone and it'll sound like you're in a windstorm while you're doing it. So I don't do it while I'm filming. And I'll just wipe these off right here. And like I said in my other video, I always make the wire just a little bit longer and then cut it off to the length that I need it. Now I'm going to set this up. Now I'm not sure if this is how this is, but I'm going to have to take my meter and test it to see if there's any coating over top of that pad. Okay, you can see that. And I'll just put the leads on these pads to see if we get continuity. Okay, so I'm not going to have to clean them off because there's no insulation on them. So we're good to go on that. I peeled back a little bit so I could expose the tape, and I'm just going to let it sit on here so this doesn't move when I'm soldering. So the first thing I'm going to do is put some liquid flux on the two pads. And what I'll do is I'll drop a bit of solder on each one of the pads. Put that right there. And just drop the solder on there like that. Okay, now we got a good soldering surface right there. I don't have to mess with holding the solder in one hand. So we're gonna take this, we're gonna shorten this up a little bit. And I'm gonna bend it slightly. All right, and make sure that side is the negative. Yeah, that side's the negative. Okay, I'm gonna put a little bit more flux on that. And we're just gonna set it on the solder. And then up this down. Okay, that's the black wire. We'll do the same with the red. We'll shorten it up a little bit. Get a better grip on this, like right there. Okay. Make sure it's into the solder. There we go. I'll bring this up off of there. Test this out now. Black over here, red over here. And there we go. We got them lit up. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a little bit of liquid tape on top of that. I'm gonna put these a little bit closer together. Twist these just a little bit, right there. You could use any kind of tape to cover up that solder joint, but I'm gonna use this right here. It's a liquid tape. And you can get this anywhere. I have this. I got this through Amazon. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put the paper towel underneath there. This stuff is very flammable, so don't be using this near an open flame. And don't be breathing the fumes on here. I'm just gonna cover it up like that. And that will just keep it from shorting out on anything. And when I did this, I turned off my soldering iron so I wouldn't have any heat source near this stuff, because this stuff is highly flammable. So if you can, do it outside or do it with a fan on and not like I do it here.
Well, it's been about 15 minutes and this is starting to get a little bit hard. There's a crust on the outside coating of it. You know, you can't break through it, but it's still a little soft. So it might take maybe 20 to 30 minutes for this to harden all the way. But anyway, you see that you could take this apart at any three LEDs. You can make them as long as you want and as short as you want, and solder leads onto it and it'll still work. Now, you could use this anywhere on your layout. It comes in several different colors. This is bright white. It comes in soft white, which I have on the individual surface mount, or the warm white, which I have on the individual surface mount LEDs that I showed you in a previous video. But anyway, there's a lot of uses for LEDs right now, even in your locomotive, and those are the very, very small LEDs that I will get into maybe in January sometime once I get back from the holiday vacation. So I hope you learned something from this. I tried to show you every possible LED that I have, at least the LEDs that I have. I have the ones that are on a tape, the surface mount LEDs, the string LEDs, and individual LEDs, how to work with them and what resistors to use on them. On here, you don't have to worry about it because they already have the resistors on there. Now, this is 12 volts, and some of the other ones that I showed you are different voltages, so you have to look at the particular LEDs that you're using to see what voltage they are. Now, if I tried this on a lower voltage, it wouldn't work, but some of the other ones, like the surface mount LEDs, those are 3 0.3 volt. So that those will work on the power supply that I have that has a 3-volt terminal on it. So just be careful to make sure that you know what the voltage is of your LED and make sure you have a current limiting resistor on them so you don't burn them out. And you'll be fine. You could use them anywhere on your layout. And in January, I'll show you how I put them in my buildings.